So what is this decision matrix or PO matrix, and how does it helps in the concept selection by shortening a long list of alternatives or options down to just one or two? So we will look at all this, including the concept, with the help of some animated examples. So please watch each and every step to understand this concept fully. Decision matrix is a kind of prioritization matrix that allows us to choose between the list of alternatives or options based on certain criteria, with the ultimate aim to reduce that options down to one option. It is normally employed after we have captured the voice of the customer. The decision matrix, which is also known as the PO matrix, was developed by Stuart Pugh. The PO matrix basically helps you determine which items or potential solutions are more important, or in other words, better than the other options. Several concepts are evaluated against a datum or a reference concept, which is the best current concept that the team has till date. PO matrix can be used in wide range of applications like concept selection, vendor selection, project selection, and in some financial decisions as well. It is known by different names as well, like PO matrix, decision matrix or decision grid, and opportunity analysis. Let us now see what are the steps that are involved in constructing a PO matrix or a decision matrix. So we will take a reference sample template for our reference purpose, and we will start listing down the first step. The first step is we will list all the important criteria here that will be used for evaluation. So this we will list down in the vertical extreme left column. Second step is to define your datum or a baseline. So datum is the initial or the most feasible solution, and every alternative or option will be evaluated against this particular datum. Finally, we will also list all your alternatives in the horizontal column. All your options, all your solutions that you have that you want to compare against your baseline or datum. Now, we need to rank all these options against baseline. So, plus means it is better than the baseline. Minus means it is worse than the baseline. And zero means it is same. Next, we need to come up with the aggregate total. Like for option 1, we are getting minus 1 and minus 1 against the criteria. So we aggregates to minus 2. For option 2, it is like plus 1 and 0, which aggregates to plus 1. And option 3 is like 0. Then we need to come up with the rank based on this final outcome. So out of this, the option 2 has the highest total, plus 1. Which is our rank 1. Let's take an example here. Suppose our objective is to evaluate which car to choose out of sports car, luxury car, an SUV or a vintage car. So we will use this technique of PO concept matrix and see which car we want to choose based on certain criteria. So we'll continue with the same example. So this is our template. So in the extreme left column, we will list down all the criteria that we have decided based on brainstorming. So the criteria could be mileage, style, safety features like airbags, overall cost, and how spacious that car is. Next, we need to define our baseline or datum or a reference. So in this case, we will select our current datum and we will evaluate all our options against this particular datum. Next, we will define our options or alternatives that we have. First is your sports car. Second is your luxury car. Third is your family car. And then finally, any vintage car. So these are my options in the top horizontal column. The last two rows are the total and the rank. Now we will give the numbers as 0 for the baseline. This is our initial benchmark. Now we will compare all our concepts or options against this benchmark. So for against each criteria, we will list plus 1 if it is better than the baseline, 0 if it is same as baseline, and minus 1 if it is worse than baseline. So we'll start with the sports car. The sports car in terms of mileage, it is worse. Same is for luxury car, we're giving it as minus 1. Family car has same mileage as the baseline and same as for vintage car. In terms of style, sports car is definitely plus 1. Same fare for luxury car as plus 1. Family car is also plus 1 and same for vintage car. In terms of safety features, like sports car had additional safety options like airbag, may not be in the luxury car, but yes, the family car do have that additional safety features, and maybe not be in the, it is same as what we have in the current baseline. Cost wise, is the sports car is very costly in comparison to what the baseline has. Same goes for luxury car. Even the family car is an upgraded version, so it is a little costly, and vintage car as well. So we are comparing all these with the baseline that we have shown. Spacious wise, like our sports car is not that spacious if we compare it with the baseline. Luxury car is same as what we have in the baseline. Family car is more spacious than the baseline. And vintage car is same as what we have in the baseline. So now that we have given all the ranks to it, let's calculate the total out of it. The sports car total is coming, if you sum up all this, is as minus 1. Same goes for luxury car, it is coming as minus 1. Family car is coming as plus 2. And vintage car is coming as plus 1. Now we will give the rank based on. So our first rank is coming based on the aggregate total to the family car. Our second option is the vintage car. So the output of this matrix is that the family car is the right option for you. So we have just listed the four options and four or five criteria. You can have n number of options or criteria. And you can evaluate which option is best based on number of criteria. I hope you understand this concept of PU matrix or decision matrix. So that is all I have on this video. If you like it, click here to subscribe. Do hit the like button as well and share this video with all your friends on different social media platforms. And if you have any specific comments or suggestions, you can leave your suggestions in the comment section below.